Tapemar con Monette. When I was just a wee boy, my mother said to me, "You're no washing your face, Rick, son. That's very plain to see. There's tatties growing out your lugs and a tide mark on your neck." I was scared stiff and I didn't ken just what was coming next. As I headed off to school that day, my mother's words rung in my ears. "If the tatties in my lugs fell out, I'd look a numpty," which was one of my worst fears. As for the tide mark round my neck, would my school chums decide if it was caused by lack of soap and water or lying on the Weems beach during a high tide? Well, I got over the little worries, but my mum had mair in store. One day she stopped me for going out, as mocha underwear I wore. My mum said, "Put on clean underpants and dinna moan or mak a fuss, just in case by some quirk of fate you get knocked down by a bus." I knew my head felt like a pundleman's by my mum's old Scottish words and ways, and there was much more to come in my ensuing boyhood days. Manners were her passion, she would lay down the law. I couldn't speak when at the table, as children should be seen, but never heard at all. I was dealt need talking with my mouth through. I would say thank you and say please, and I would get a scalp at lug if I was caught telling lees. You'd go and bend the scullery for your breakfast, fetch your baffies for the press, get clays out the store on apro. There was nae such thing as stress. I wonder what the fish was that I was dealt to hud. I didn't came where my dad was gone when he went out to see a man about a dug. Have you ever been dealt your glaikit, a wee skinner or a clipe? Did you get dumps on your birthday? Was you a canny or crabbit type? Beelin' breeks and behooky, hixie pixie, bawk and yaff. Get lowry gan your dinger, these words they make me laugh. Your great old Scots mother tongue must not die out, it must survive. It's part of the proud Scottish heritage and it must be kept alive.